So yesterday I had to go back to my hometown to attend the funeral of a family member who recently passed away after a long battle with cancer. She was a very important person in my life and actually had a lot to do with why I became a veterinarian. As I was driving back home, I did a lot of thinking about this YouTube channel and the reason why I have it. The whole point of this channel is to provide good information in an entertaining way so that people can use that information to help their pets live the longest, happiest life possible. Unfortunately, another big part of my job is helping pet owners whenever they end up having to make end-of-life decisions for their pets. Now, I usually try to make these videos entertaining and fun and sometimes funny, but in this particular situation, I just want to have a serious conversation about euthanasia. Now, some people are completely against euthanasia, and I don't have a problem with that. But this video is going to be for those owners who have pets who are really old or potentially suffering from some chronic disease and do consider euthanasia as a viable option. Both human and veterinary medicine have come a long way, but eventually we all get to a point where no amount of medicine is going to help. And in the case of veterinary medicine, that means potentially having a conversation about euthanasia. When it comes time to have this conversation, a large portion of the owners that I speak with ask me directly if I think that they should euthanize. And the answer that I usually give is that that's not a decision that I can make for you. But I can at least help those owners decide whether their pet is truly suffering and has no quality of life. They're genuinely afraid that by even considering euthanasia, they may be being selfish or rash. But at the same time, they're also concerned that they're being selfish by allowing their pet to continue to suffer whenever there's nothing that we can do medically to improve their quality of life. This is the advice that I give them. And I caution you, please, before you make any decisions based on this video, go see your regular veterinarian, because you may have unique circumstances that will completely change what I would say. But in general, here's what I usually recommend. Pick three things that gives your pet that personality that separates it from any other dog or cat or whatever animal your pet may be. This may be a routine that you have every morning. They may get up to greet you every time you come home. They may have a certain window that they love to curl up and nap by. They may come in bed with you every night. They may have a particular treat that no matter how sick they are, they're still going to eat that treat. Just basically three things that makes your pet an individual and not some random animal that you come across. As those things start to go away, by the time that third trait or characteristic is gone, in my opinion, the quality of life for that pet has gone down to the point where they don't even have the personality that makes them the individual that they are. Now, there may be individual circumstances that get your pet to the point where you may need to consider euthanasia before all of those criteria are met. And that's why it's really important that you at least have a conversation with your veterinarian to make sure that that is the right thing to do. Ultimately, this may not make it any easier for you to make the decision, but a lot of times I feel that the owners of my patients are more than satisfied with using these criteria before they make the decision to euthanize. And believe me when I say that I understand that even with what sounds like the best criteria for this consideration, when it comes time to actually make the decision, it can still be gut-wrenching. And I speak from personal experience. So I hope that if this is something that you're having to deal with, this video will at least help give you a little bit of guidance, or at least a little bit of comfort when it comes time to make your decision. I promise the next video is going to be back to my usual fun and silly approach, but I felt like I needed to make a serious one for this particular subject. Before I go, I have to stress one more time that it's very important that you make this decision with your veterinarian. Sometimes there are things that we can do medically to help alleviate suffering and improve quality of life, but every individual case is unique, and only your veterinarian can help you with that information and help you make an informed decision. So I guess that's about it. If you're going through this particular situation, believe me, I feel for you, and I'll see you next time.